Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to edit one of the photos that I took in the previous video, which is the squirrel photo.
Huh. Oh my God, a squirrel. Stay.
I ran after that squirrel so much. It was so tiring. If you haven't seen the video, go check it out. And today we're going to edit that photo together and then print it. So let's dive in. And now we are in Lightroom. First, let's remove all the settings that I did and start from scratch. So right out of the camera, it looks like this. I'm not sure why it is so dark. It was not that dark, but this is how Lightroom is interpreting my RAW files. So first I started by increasing the shadows to see my squirrel more, and then I can edit and start from here. After increasing the shadows, I might like to decrease the blacks a little bit so they don't go high too. And then I started applying my local adjustments. First thing I did is to edit the subject. I feel like the squirrel is way darker than the background. So I did subject select. It works well most of the time. In this case, it didn't work well. I need to add a little bit of editing or manual editing. So I added a little bit here. And then I will increase the exposure so I can see this little guy a little bit more, maybe around here, and then decrease the blacks. As I said, I don't like them to go high, too high. And then because he's in the shadows, he's a little bit cold, not cold as in weather-wise, but color-wise. So I like to make it a little bit warmer if something is in the shadows. Now it's a little bit even. Now let's do local adjustment to the background. So to do that, I duplicate and invert this mask. And now all my edits will be to the background. You can do better masking here, but now I'm just doing a quick edit. So the background, in my opinion, it was too contrasty. So I reduced the contrast a little bit. So the focus is on the squirrel, not on the background. Increase the exposure a little bit. I know that we want him to be popping, but maybe a little bit we increase the exposure of the background. And then I want this bokeh that's here to pop a little bit more, so I increase that as well. Not very much effect. And then a little bit warmer. I want it to be warmer, like it's sunny, it's a nice day. I want the background to be so soft, so I will decrease some of the things here. The texture, I don't want it to be noisy or anything, so I decrease the texture soft. And then also the clarity, I don't want it to be, I don't know how to describe it, but you can see the effect of too much clarity, low clarity, so a little bit reducing the clarity here. And then the dehaze, normally dehazing does this. I want the opposite of that. I want the haze. I want to feel that it's so soft. When I did that, I felt like the background has lost saturation. So I'm going to now increase that saturation up. So we have the colors more. We increase. I think maybe around here is good. Now I feel like it's too bright. So okay, I think I'm happy with this result. So now I want to apply a local adjustment to the background. I like to make the right side here brighter to show that the sun was coming from the right side. To do that, I'm gonna select the background, subtract from this background effect by a linear gradient until I have the red tint only on the place that I want. This is a bit confusing sometimes. So now I know that my effect will only be on the right side of the background. And then here I'm gonna increase the exposure from the right side like this, and increase also the temperature like this a little bit, to not that much, maybe a little bit like this, to show that the sun is coming from the right side, it's brighter, and also it is warmer. The effect is too strong. Let's give it more gradient. Okay, like this. And then what I like, it's something that I learned recently, and I do it a lot, is to give like a light sun ray beam, something like that. So I do an oval like this. And then I do it like this to mimic a light ray that's coming and hitting the subject. And to do that, I like to make it too warm. Too warm, like orangey like this, increasing the temperature and increasing the exposure also, because when you have a light coming, it's brighter, maybe this much. And also I like to decrease the dehaze. There is a light beam that's coming and giving the photo some haze. Let's reduce it more. Yeah, like this. So if we see before and after, like this. I like this effect a lot. Maybe it is touching the subject too much, so we control it by this one, like this. Just touching the subject a little bit. So that's what I like to do. You can increase the feather and decrease it like this. Yeah, play around with this one. And then what I like to do is to make this subject pop more by making it a little bit 3D. And that's something also that I learned recently, and I like to do it a lot. You can see the effect, and we will do before and after. So first I take a brush, because it's a local adjustment, very local. And then I decrease the exposure, maybe like this, and then decrease the flow, because I'm going to apply this to some places, and if I like it, I will reapply it many times. Before and after. I think it's nice. And then we do the same thing, but for highlights. And to do that, also the brush, low flow, and then I increase the exposure to, let's overdo it in the adjustment here, but then with a low flow, you don't affect so much. We increase the temperature, and then we start applying it. Let's see a little bit before and after. Before and after. I like this effect a lot. Lastly, I think this side is too saturated and draws so much attention, so I will decrease the saturation there by doing a linear gradient. Here. So I decrease the saturation. And then there is this important step, which is color adjustments. I forgot to record it, but I added it to the video, which is changing the colors, specifically choosing each color and changing it. What I did here is I changed the greens to be a little bit more yellowish, and the yellows a little bit orangey, and so on. And that adds the last touch that makes the photo really good. And this is before, and this is after, again. And that's it. This is how I edited this photo. In the next video, we are going to print it and see how it turns out. So tune in for that video.